Friday, December 6th, under the command of Chief Richard DiGiacomo, 52 Long Beach firefighters and another 25 from neighboring departments worked together to extinguish a fire at 668 West Broadway. It was a wind-driven fire which caused dangerous conditions for the interior teams. Due to the coordinated effort by the members of the scene, the situation was quickly averted, allowing all firefighters to go home safely while saving the entire structure. Thank you to all of our firefighters in Long Beach, including four paid firefighters and 48 volunteer firefighters who worked together under extreme and dangerous conditions. We would also like to thank the many firefighters who assisted from the following departments: Lawrence Cedarhurst, Oceanside, Island Park, Point Lookout, Lido, Inwood, Woodmere, and Rockville Center. In light of the recent attack in Jersey City, the Long Beach Police Department instituted enhanced patrols of religious institutions of all faiths within the city to provide increased protection against potential threats. The department has maintained a database of all upcoming holidays and an updated list of emergency contacts for emergency planning purposes. These measures, along with incorporating routine yet irregularly timed patrols of religious institutions, allows the Long Beach Police Department to provide a visible deterrent to would-be assailants. Better determine where additional resources are needed and reassure worshipers of all faiths that they are both welcome and protected in our city by the city. The electric light parade in the West End was a tremendous success on Saturday night. It's a great example of the city and the chamber working together to put on a wonderful community event. Thanks to Carrie Ann Troy, Tracy Murray, and Jamie Lynch for coordinating this great event. The city clerk's office has announced that the 2020 residential parking permits are on sale now. Permits may be purchased at the clerk's office from 307 in City Hall Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., or by mail. The office of the city clerk will be open late on Tuesday, January 7th and 21st until 7 p.m. The city of Long Beach is currently developing a floodplain management plan. The FNP documents the city's vulnerability to flood hazards and the city's strategy to reduce that vulnerability. We are pleased to have chamber representation on our planning committee. There will be a public meeting to discuss flood vulnerability and the planning process tomorrow, Wednesday, December 18th, from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. The meeting will be held at Long Beach City Hall, on Westchester Street, Long Beach, New York, on the sixth floor, and all address of residents and businesses and other stakeholders invited to attend. For more information on the community rating system, please visit www.longbeachny.gov/CRS. The City of Long Beach will hold the blood drive on December 26th from 2 to 8 p.m. at the Ice Arena located at 150 West Bay Drive. The donation will help save three lives. The city's Christmas tree lighting took place a couple of weeks ago and was a great event. Now looking ahead next week, all are invited to celebrate Hanukkah as we light the menorah each night in Kennedy Plaza beginning on Sunday, December 22nd at 5 p.m. Enjoy the great chocolate gelt drop, hot potato lattes, jelly donuts, and hot coffee. Please call 516-574-3905 for more information. All are welcome to come down to the city's first night celebration on New Year's Eve at the Long Beach Ice Arena. This is a family-friendly event. It will also include live music and kids' arts and crafts party courtesy of the Long Beach Arts Council. Visit the city's website for more details. And just to wrap up tonight's update, I wanted to wish everyone and their families a happy Festivus. For the rest of us, and a wonderful holiday season, and all the best in 2020.
Thank you.